Apple is leveled out. Time for some insulation, 16 centimeter thick. This is 8, so we insulate double. So all these bolts, M12, is around 50 newton meter. That's all good. So M16 is like 80 newton meter. I mean, yeah, 80, something like that. We're gonna do the roof also. So we're placing the pipes, rain pipes. Oh, put some grease on it. It's easier. Oh, okay. Some grass. Wait, some grass. Get it out. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Can push. Gonna do the corners like this, so it's easy to close the corner good, because I can glue this DPC against this DPC, which is waterproofed already. So okay. Put our PPC. Oh. Boom. Boom. Let's start in the middle. So it looks like this. This is the first piece, the second one. So it's all watertight. Third one comes over it. It's gonna be all right. Plug here, the sheet. Check this. Yummy. All right, next. Like that, huh? Glued. So we can start with the bricks. We did all the preparations with preparations, which means my profiles, level on it, lintel is ready, insulation partly done, and the DPC is finished. So now it's we need to start cutting bricks, because we're gonna work the lintel in the bricks, make the bricks flush, the downside of the brick flush with the lintel like that. Okay, I'm wet, it's time to go home. So the water is just running out of down from the roof, on the wall, drops on the insulation. Our DPC is behind the insulation, it catches the water and it guides the water out. You can see it clearly here. It will keep our wall dry, this DPC. So I made my gauge stick again. One course is 4.3 centimeter or 43 millimeter. You can see it here. If I measure 10 courses, I should come at 43 centimeter, almost 43. Oh wait, yeah, it's 43. Yeah, almost a little bit, one millimeter off. So 43 like that. Let's gauge them up. Let's gauge it up. Nylon, 1 millimeter. For a brickwork, I like to have a thin line. Let's change this one. Put this one. Not too hard, that's good.
that's a whirlpool.
The roof is pitching. Now let's drill a hole in the first floor. Thank you. 3,5. Here we are. Okay, here it's so working within joints is always more difficult, because you have no room to play, only 3 millimeter joint. It's really, really thin, you know. So jointing up afterwards will be very difficult. But here we have like a little corner till the window, but they want us to wait with this corner, because they want to close the window with rubber or EPDM. And if we close the wall here, they can't fix the window anymore. So we're gonna wait. But that's more difficult. I'm gonna leave a tooth, a standing tooth. And hopefully we can connect it properly later. I know now it's gonna be difficult. I know this for sure. Here I leave open because this course still continue that way. Okay, let's do it. So again, this corner here against the window, it's gonna give me problems. I know it's gonna be difficult to make it, but I don't know another. Yeah, the other solution is make a tooth like this, but I don't feel like doing it. So I just try. We're gonna try. Nice header. Thank you. cut them a bit in. I had other ones, but they're too difficult to work with. It's like the steel is too stiff to bend, so I buy normal ones. I bought normal ones. We did a lot today on a Monday. Not bad for a Monday. All right, scaffolds up. This is gonna be difficult. Thin joints, I don't know how I'm gonna do it. We'll see. The window is here. I can't close this because they need to fix the window in the wall there. If I close this, I don't know how they're gonna do that. Too bad, but that's how it is. Tie-ins, we drill them now. Then we make a course and then we put tie-ins in. We're almost there. Few courses. After that piece, it's just this piece here. And the windows we wait. So, yeah, we'll be pretty fast done, pretty quickly. Open head joints. I know it will be shocking to some of you. We're used to it in Belgium. It's just nothing special, I guess. It's just this style of brickwork. So this is my cavity. It's pretty damn clean. Yes, sir. It has to be. Oh, so clean. Yeah, this is approved. Approved. I'm showing off. So, one more thing. This tree here, Castagna bomb? I don't know. But when it rains, the tree makes this corner very dirty. If you can see my scaffold, we set this scaffold a few days ago, and it's already like brown, like a rust color. It's severe, huh? It's not just a bit. So we're gonna cover the brickwork to prevent the brickwork will be colored brown. That wouldn't be so good. I already told the owner and the architect about this. Somebody need to do something about the tree, like a tree surgeon. It's like a tree doctor. They need to, yeah, do something without it, because the tree is like protected. You can't just take it down. It's not allowed. So yeah, the open head joints, I guess most people will find it shocking. For me personally, I wouldn't. If I build my house, I won't go for this style. But it's the job, so we gotta do it like this. It's not that I invent this stuff, eh? I just do what they ask me to do, so. But it's pretty known in Belgium. A lot of people like it. So you see it quite often here in Belgium. In Holland also, eh? Holland, Belgium, the rest I don't know. All the brickwork from this house starts on the first floor, eh? Not on the ground floor. There is absolutely no brickwork on the ground floor. It all starts on the lintels all around. So this is the last course for here. Nice.
The plywood.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my, these are two bricks. Yeah, it's good to do actually, yeah.
Okay, scaffold's gone. Awesome. Ah, solo mio. Some guano. I want some guano. Our wall looks a bit more darker because it's a little bit more wet. But man, it's good, huh? Show this kind of brickwork without any head joints, because I know there are gonna be a lot of shit talkers. Belgium and Holland,
We have so many styles and so many styles of bricks, brickwork and jointing up, or no jointing at all, like here, just thin joints. It keeps everything a bit interesting, not so boring. I mean, we always have like a different brick to work with, a different color or measure, size.